think The Sound of Light is a very suggestive title. It's the first time, actually, that the title went through without a hitch when my publisher asked me, what's it going to be? How do you want to call it? And that's I was really glad about that. It's very much about the Northern Light and about the sounds the Northern Lights make. Nobody has ever heard them, really. I mean, I think there are some Norwegian scientists who've actually discovered the sound of the Northern Lights, some kind of banging sound in the polar region while there was Northern Lights, a display of Northern Lights. But really, there have been so many recordings and so many different testimonies about the noise of the Northern Lights, but nobody's ever heard it. And I think it's sort of probably some kind of fiction anyway. And if it does exist, and nobody knows why, and nobody can explain why it is. So it is a kind of mystery. And for me, it is also a very deep silence, which somehow becomes a noise in itself, and is also a bit like a story. And it reminds me, for example, of listening to the sound of a dead shell, and then hearing the sea. You know, that kind of projection or that kind of fiction. Yes, it's very much a novel about waiting, and it takes place in a waiting room in a neurologist's practice. But so the actual frame narration is only about 2 hours, really. And but of course the whole novel has different stories, which again they reach over long times and long years, and this is exactly what's going on or what happens when you wait. That sometimes time changes and things while you wait, it stretches out into infinity. Whereas when you look back, it hasn't really taken place. It's a kind of time that doesn't exist. And I think very similar things go on when you tell a story or when you hear a story. Stories and storytelling can do something with time. And that's what I wanted to achieve. This, on the one hand, you have this waiting, and everybody has a story about waiting. And on the other hand, time sort of expands and shrinks at the same time. And I chose this form or the structure of having five single stories held together by the waiting room narrator. I wanted to have those stories all thought of by one character. I think that's, for me, that's the most important thing. All these stories come out of the brain of one person. And it starts as a kind of game. So she looks at the other patients and she wonders who they are and why they are here. I mean, this is what one does when you go to a doctor and you don't want to think about yourself. So I think, and so this is what she does. She doesn't want to think about herself, and so she makes up all the stories of the other people in the room, and hiding maybe her own story within those stories. I think Canada is the ideal country of projection, at least for Europeans. It's adventurous. It's really empty. You know, hardly anybody lives there. It's so big, and even when you look at a map, it's white. It's the big white blank page that needs to be written on.